more white man lie.
Isaiah chapter 58 verse 1.
Uh-huh.
Cry aloud.
Do what?
Cry aloud.
Uh-huh.
We spare not.
Spare not. So we don't care about your opinions, about your feelings. We're going to tell you what God says.
That's
not
right.
Not what man say, but what God says.
Right. Lift up thy voice like a trumpet.
So that's why we're out here. We're lifting up our voice. Why? To show you your sins. To tell you that you must repent.
Read. And show my people.
Show who?
My people.
So his people are who? The Israelites.
That's
the house of Israel. The Most High God don't deal with all nations. The Most High God deals with one nation, and that's this right here, the nation of Israel.
Right? Read. Their transgression.
Their what?
Their transgression.
Does anybody know what that is? A transgression. Brother, what is that? A transgression. What's a transgression? Anybody? Sister, what's a transgression?
It's your own. It's your own discretion.
Let's get it out of the scriptures. First, let's see what God says.
Read. 1 John chapter 3, verse 4.
Uh-huh.
Whosoever committeth sin,
uh-huh,
transgresseth also the law.
Read.
For sin is the transgression of the law.
So sin is the breaking of God's law. Okay? So let me ask you something, sis. Are you in the midst of sin right now? Because remember, we out here to show Israel their sins. Are you in the midst of sin? Yes, ma'am.
What people doing around me?
No, just you as of right now.
No.
You're not?
No.
Let me show you something real quick.
I know I was born to sin and shaking iniquity. But Christ died on the cross and forgave me of my sins. So I walk. Personally, I don't care about
anybody
else, but personally, I walk in righteousness.
You walk in righteousness?
In his righteousness.
Okay, let me ask you something then, because you said that you walk in righteousness. What is righteousness? Right standing with God, okay? Let me get you the scripture that explains what righteousness is.
Bring it out.
Okay, read that.
Deuteronomy chapter 6, verse 25.
Come here, sis.
And it should be...
I invite you. Read.
And it should be... Our righteousness.
Remember now, you said righteousness is what? The right standing with God. Okay, let's see what God says. Read.
Deuteronomy chapter 6, verse 25.
Uh-huh.
And it shall be our righteousness.
So this is talking about our righteousness, right? Read.
If we observe
uh-huh.
to do all these commandments.
So what is righteousness? Observe.
Observe to do all these commandments.
Uh-huh.
Before the Lord our God.
So righteousness is keeping God's laws. So, are you keeping God's laws?
Yeah.
You are? Let me show you something there real quick. Let me bring out a scripture to paint. Let me get you a scripture and you let me know if you are in the midst of that sin or not. Because you say that you live in righteousness, right? Let's see.
In his righteousness. Right. And then as I know.
Yeah.
Okay.
Deuteronomy chapter 22, verse 5.
Uh-huh.
The woman.
The who?
The woman.
That's you, right? The
yes.
woman.
Yes.
Shall not wear that which pertaineth unto a man.
So, what do women wear that pertains to a man? Pants, right?
No. Women wear pants and men wear pants just because, look in history.
Men's wore skirts. Let's look at history. You can't say pants are men's. This is your foremothers right here, right? In slavery, right? Bring it out. What were they wearing? Let's talk about history. What are they wearing? Right here. What are they wearing? Yeah, they wearing skirts. They're wearing dresses, right? Why? Why did they wear dresses?
I don't know.
Because that's what God says.
That's right.
Men wear pants and trousers, women wear dresses. You understand that?
One second.
What'd you say now, sis?
Show me that in the word.
Bring it out.
Huh?
The pants.
Show me that in the word.
Hey. And say it in
I got you.
You get into the material thing. God is a spirit.
God is a spirit.
God is a spirit. Right?
Okay.
And he deals with the spirit of the heart. That's where the righteousness have to be. It can't be in apparel or the appearance of the outside. It has to be on the inside. The righteousness on the inside has nothing to do with what's on the outside or what
Let's
I wear.
Read this scripture for you. 1 second.
Exodus chapter 28. Verse 42.
Uh-huh.
And thou shalt make them linen breeches.
What are breeches?
Pants.
Who?
Pants.
Down south, he call them breeches. Grandma said, pull up your breeches, right? Talking about your pants. Read, right? Read.
To cover their nakedness.
To cover their nakedness, right? So the pants was made to cover the nakedness of who? Read.
From the loins even into the thighs.
So from the loins all the way down. Just like you wear from the loins all the way down. But who is this for?
They shall reach, and they shall be upon Aaron.
Uh-huh.
And upon his sons.
His who?
His sons.
What about the daughters?
His sons.
Read. That's it. Read.
When they come in into the tabernacle of the congregation.
Now, it said their sons. I didn't hear daughters in there.
Right.
I didn't.
You concerned? You basing righteousness on the outside of the wearing the outside of the apparel?
I'm basing but righteousness on God's law.
That's right.
That's
that word was written by man, so there can be like a little error. If you're focusing your righteousness on the outside of the apparel, God righteousness in His glory, wearing the glory of God on you. That's what righteousness, yes, the glory of God. That's what he wants his people to wear.
Now, give me some.
The glory.
In verse 9, I believe it is. Because you said that we're supposed to wear something, right?
132. That's what
the righteousness
is. In verse 9. That's what you need
to be out here. Let me show you what we should wear. Let me show you, sis. Read.
Psalms chapter 132, verse 9. Let thy priest.
Let thy who?
Let thy priest.
Read.
Be clothed with righteousness.
The Bible says that we must be clothed in righteousness. Meaning what? You must keep God's laws.
That's right.
That's what you should be wearing. God's laws, which is what? You need to get out of those pants.
That's right.
There is a consequence for you wearing those pants.
Bring it up.
Let me tell you this.
Yes, sir.
When I gave myself to the Lord, I did take off the pants. Because I found that the people that had me taking off my pants was unrighteous.
Okay.
And the righteousness wasn't in taking off my pants, taking off my earrings. I wore them for years. I did it for years. I went going to the beach, going with long skirts.
What you preaching is not.
We're talking about God. God is a spirit. He dwells in the heart of man. We're talking about righteousness. We're talking about the glory of God need to be worn on us. The priest, you mentioned the priest. It talks about the priest wore the fruits and the spirit and the gifts and the spirit on his bottle of his what you call it. That's what we're supposed to wear. We're supposed to wear the gifts.
Sis, you're supposed to keep God's laws.
That's right.
Speak your words. We come out of the Bible. The Bible said that you're supposed to wear what pertains to a woman, which is a dress. That's what you're supposed to read.
Exodus chapter 15, verse 3. The Lord is a man of war.
You said that God is a spirit, right? But read it again.
The Lord is a man of war.
Explain that. You just said that God is spirit, but the scripture says something wrong.
He's a man of war.
He is because, a man.
Right. Okay, well, so we're talking about Christ because God came as a man on the earth as Christ.
Oh, wow.
As Christ. And he walked. You talking about a man?
No.
Or we're Christ talking about God dwelling in man.
Christ and the Most High God are two different beings.
That's right.
They are two different beings. They're not the same.
No, you got Christ.
Give me I don't want to jump. Go back to Isaiah chapter 2:1.
Isaiah
bring it
chapter
out.
52, verse 1.
Uh-huh.
Awake, awake.
Listen to this script. Listen. Read.
Awake, awake. Put on thy strength.
Put on thy what?
Put on thy strength.
Uh-huh.
O Zion.
O Zion, which is who? The Israelites. The Israelites. Okay, read.
Put on thy beautiful garments.
Put on that what?
Put on thy beautiful garments.
So you wearing pants, sister. That's not beautiful.
He's talking
about cross-dressing.
The heart of the spirit.
Bring
we're talking about gifts and fruit. We're talking about long suffering, joy, peace. If everybody was out here
in this world, they were.
Let's see if this spiritual or not. Read.
And it shall come to pass in the day of the Lord's sacrifice that I will punish the princes and the king's children.
Read.
In all such as are clothed with strange apparel.
What does that mean? Strange apparel. Is that spiritual or physical?
We're talking about, but go back in. I wish I had the scripture, because he talks about the appearance in the heart. Not the plaiting of the hair. Not the plaiting of the hair. Get that scripture. Not the plaiting of the hair. Not the plaiting of the hair. Not
the garment. And it shall come to pass. And it shall come to pass in the day of the Lord's sacrifice that I will punish the princes and the king's children.
Break that down, because she's break that down.
Okay, one more time.
And it shall come to pass.
It shall come to pass, read.
In the day of the Lord's sacrifice.
What is that? What is that? When Christ returns, right? No, when Christ returns.
That's right.
Because when Christ returns, it's not going to be bubble gums and lollipops.
That's right.
Those that sin. Those that sin, he's coming to kill.
Right.
Read.
That I will punish the princes and the king's children.
The king's who?
The king's children. And all.
These people right here, the Israelites. The king's who?
The king's children.
Read.
And all such as are clothed with strange apparel.
So, let me ask you again. Sister, what is strange apparel? What is that? What? No. What is apparel?
If he can find circumcision circumcision of the heart, because
ask
see.
What is apparel?
Do you believe Jesus died on the cross?
Yes, he did.
Okay, then you know that all of that law. You're talking about the law,
yes,
and you're talking about the law and all the law and all of that was passed when Jesus came. When Jesus came and died and resurrected, all of that went away. Right. It went away, and now he's establishing his kingdom in the hearts of men.
Okay, so look, you said that the laws are done away with, basically, right? Are the laws done away with? Are the laws done away with? So what are you saying then? What are you saying?
What I'm saying is you're talking about the outside appearance of righteousness. It's not about what we wear on the outside. It's about what our hearts are being developed into Christ, which is love, joy, peace, long-suffering.
Matthew chapter 5, verse 17.
Uh-huh.
Bring it up. Think not that I come to destroy the law.
So who is speaking right here? Jesus Christ. Christ is saying think not. So don't even think that the laws are done away with. Read.
Or the prophets.
Or the prophets,
I am not come to destroy, but to fulfill.
So he said that he did not come to destroy the law, but to what? Fulfill the prophecies. So, guess what? The law of you wearing a dress is still in effect.
That's right.
Let me ask you something. Your grandmother, did she wear pants? Your great-grandmother, did she wear pants?
I don't know. I can't speak for them.
Okay,
right.
Let me ask you this.
That right there from the white man.
From slavery.
Uh-huh. From America. Babylon the Great.
Ask me this question. What this got to do with my heart?
I'm just go back to
the joy of the Lord. Isaiah
29 and 13.
All the fruits of the spirit that God wants you to wear on walking on this earth.
Read.
Isaiah chapter 29, verse 13.
Uh-huh.
Wherefore the Lord said, for as much as this people draw near me with their mouth.
So that's what you're doing now, right? You love the Lord, right? You follow God. He's in my heart, right? That's what you're saying, right? Read.
And with their lips do honor me.
That's what you're doing. With your lips, you saying that you worship God. That you love God, right? Read.
But have removed their heart far from me.
So guess what? Your mind is far from this Bible. That's coming from, read it. The scripture will tell you, read.
And their fear toward me is taught by the precept of men.
So guess what? You learned you learned about that wearing pants from this man right here.
That's right.
You learned that from slavery. Because guess what? Once we got here, we wasn't wearing pants. Our sisters wasn't wearing pants. They was wearing dresses.
That's right.
The way they when they worked, when they played, when they slept, they wore dresses. So how come they came over here wearing dresses and now you're wearing that?
Okay,
no, answer the question. How did that happen?
Basically you're in the process, you go through the process, if everybody else doing it, you're gonna do it too.
Exactly my
right.
point.
So right.
So you're following
who? Huh?
Men. That's what you're
right. Yeah. Every man on this earth follow me. Every man on this earth born is born into that process. You follow what you are being told and said and whatever.
Okay. We was all there.
Right.
At one.
Right.
We all follow men. But guess what? We repented. So read that.
Acts chapter 5, verse 29.
Uh-huh.
Then Peter and the other apostles answered.
Hold on. Sis. Listen to this. Brother, you listening? Y'all listening?
Yeah,
read.
That's true.
Then Peter and the other apostles answered and said, we ought to obey God rather than men.
So
that's right.
How do we obey God? By doing what it say, right? What did we just pull on? Did we just not read a law about women to wear dresses? So God said that what? We must obey him. But read from the top again.
Then Peter and the other apostles answered and said, we ought to obey God.
So we must obey this Bible, what God says, but what?
Rather than men.
But rather than what man.
That's right. Talks.
Right.
Society told you that you should wear them pants. That it's okay for you to wear pants.
Like I told you, I had a first class appearance. I took off my pants because of religion. I took them off. I took off earrings. I took off jewelry on the outside.
This is not no religion, sister.
No, listen to me.
This is
no
heritage.
Listen to me. The Holy Spirit taught me first before I went into the church. But when I went into the church,
what's your religion?
Huh?
What's your religion?
I have no religious nomination.
What were you in?
Well, basically, I was holiness.
Okay, so
holiness.
Now.
Right.
Now, let me ask you this. Give me Jeremiah chapter 3 and 15.
That's putting me in bondage. It had nothing to do with my relationship with God.
Hold up. 1 John chapter 2. 1 John chapter 2, because you said it had nothing at all. Hold up, repeat that again. Let's see what the relationship is. Read.
1 John chapter 2. Verse 3. And hereby we do know that
we do know him, meaning that what? We got a relationship with him. How? Read.
That we do know that we know him. If we keep his commandments.
If we what?
If we keep his commandments.
So the only way you know God or have a relationship with God is if you keep God's laws.
That's right.
That's it. That's why we out here telling you. We can go back and forth. We can go back and forth because look, let me ask you something else. On those pants.
Bring it up.
Sis, hold up, sis.
I live the truth. I took off my pants. I took off my earrings. I took it off. I took them off, right.
Sis, why do you need a zipper on your pants? What is a zipper made for?
These pants have nothing to do with manhood. So what? Tell me this. Why do men wear dresses in the Old Testament?
Just like you are.
Right.
Let me first speak to
that.
You keep talking about the spirit, but do you know what the spirit is? Read that.
Isaiah chapter 32, verse 9. Rise up. Ye women that are at ease, hear my voice, ye careless daughters.
That's what you got to do, sis. You got to be quiet and listen. Just like, read it again, see? You're not even listening. You got to listen. That's why we got here. You think, she think that she know everything. But she got to listen. Read it.
Rise up, ye women that are at ease.
Mm-hmm.
Hear my voice, ye careless daughters.
Uh-huh.
Give ear unto my speech.
That's what y'all must be doing. Give me 2 Timothy chapter 2 and 9. 1 Timothy chapter 2 and 9.
Bring it out.
11, I'm sorry, 11. No, start at 9.
First Timothy chapter 2 verse 9.
Uh-huh.
In like manner also.
Hold on. Sisters, look at this man right here.
Listen to the devil.
Why you sitting there listening? And that's your point right there. That's why you right. Got on those Esau. Right there. Right. Listen to him.
That's right.
Listen to the word.
Amen.
Right.
Amen.
Listen that's true. To the scripture. Don't true. Listen to no man. Listen to the scripture. Read.
First Timothy chapter 2 verse 9. In like manner also, that women adorn themselves in modest apparel.
So women must dress modestly. What does modestly mean, sister? Somebody got a dictionary? Define modestly. Read it again.
In like manner also, that women adorn themselves in modest apparel.
What's modest apparel, brother? What's modest apparel?
Modest.
M-O-D-E-S-T. Modest.
Covering up yourself.
Covering up yourself, but how? I mean, because you can wear skin-tight pants, right? But is that modest? So what modest mean?
Something that doesn't show the woman's figure.
Something that doesn't show the woman's figure. That's what dressing modestly is.
That's right.
Read it again.
In like manner also,
uh-huh.
That women adorn themselves in modest apparel.
So guess what? When you wear those pants, you are showing off your shape.
Right.
When you wear those dresses, you are showing off your the tight skin dresses, the skirts. You are showing off your shape. That's not for all men to see. Just your husband. That's the only one.
Oxford Dictionary.
Uh huh.
Definition: modest. Dressing or behaving so as to avoid. Dressing or behaving
mm-hmm.
so as to avoid indecency.
Indecency? Mm-hmm. Uh-huh.
Especially to avoid attracting sexual attention.
Mm. That's you right. See that?
Right.
The modest women wear long sleeve dresses.
Do what?
Right.
The modest women wear long sleeve dresses.
Uh-huh. So, it said that to dress modestly, you are to, avoiding men looking at you lustfully, right? And guess what? A modestly dressed woman wears long dresses, right?
You hear a long sleeve and you think a shirt.
And a long dress to go to the beach and get in the water.
You must dress modestly, meaning what? You cannot.
God wants you free.
Sexual lust. So
that has nothing to do with no sexual lust when women want to just enjoy themselves.
They wear those short dresses to attract men.
Right. What?
That's what they doing. But God said that you must dress modestly. I'm talking about the Israelite woman.
That's right.
Old and young. That's what I'm talking about. Now, give me 1 Peter chapter 2 and 9. Let me ask you something, sis. Let me ask you something. A princess, right?
Mm-hmm. Bring queen, it out,
right? What do she wear?
Mm.
Do she wear pants?
Mm. Yo.
What do you wear on your wedding day?
Right.
Yeah.
What do you wear?
A wedding garment, which is a dress.
But it's a dress, right? Dress. What do queens wear? What do?
Yeah, the average one, you'll see them in a dress.
Yeah. 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 9.
Bring it
out. But ye are a chosen generation.
Uh-huh.
A royal priesthood.
A
royal priesthood.
So guess what? You are royalty.
That's right.
Princesses, they wear what? Royalty. Meaning what? If you would not dare see a queen walking around with what? Pants on.
Right.
But they're royal.
That's it.
They're royal. Princesses are royal. Queen who?
Elizabeth.
Right. The Queen of England, right? Have you seen her wearing pants ever? Why is that? Why is that?
She riding the horse and she wears the what you call it?
When was the last time you never see her wear
wear pants.
Right.
You never
seen
that.
The only time they would do that.
They think that they're royalty.
Right.
These are royalty.
Right.
That's
right.
Right.
Right. Right. You're supposed to be wearing a dress because you're royalty.
That's right.
You wearing man pants. Cross dressing. That's what you're doing. But guess what? Read it again. Zephaniah 1 and 8. I'm trying to tell you. We're trying to save you. Because guess what? When Christ returns, he's going to do what? Sacrifice who? Those wearing strange apparel.
Right.
Going outside of the Bible, that's strange. You're acting strangely right now.
Read.
Zephaniah. Zephaniah chapter 1, verse 8. And it shall come to pass.
It shall come to pass. Listen. It shall come to pass. Read.
In the day of the Lord's sacrifice. That I will punish the princes and the king's children.
So everybody that's dressed strangely, you wearing pants. You wearing pants, sister. Read.
And all such as are clothed with strange apparel.
So what does that mean, sister? What does that mean right there? When Christ returns, if you're dressed in strangely, what's going to happen?
Christ
is cool, even though
I got on pants. That's how I feel.
Okay, Psalm 7. Isaiah chapter 55 and 8. Let's get that. Because, say that again, sister. Read that.
Isaiah chapter 55, verse 8.
Bring it up.
My thoughts are not your thoughts. Neither are your ways my ways.
So you're not on the same level as him. So God told you how you you should dress. So you are going off of your own mind, your own thoughts. This man taught you that. He said that it's okay. He said that. But God said that you're supposed to be wearing a dress modestly. So what you gonna do?
I don't like dresses. My babies don't
either. I don't like dresses. We just said that royal women wear dresses.
You can't walk around head-dressed. What do we got to run? What do we got to run from the police? Look how I grow.
Run from the police.
Run from the police.
Hell yeah, they killing y'all type people as you don't know.
So, why is that happening? No, because we're breaking God's laws.
That's right.
We're getting punished. Why? Because we keep breaking God's laws. That's why.
Shalom, Israel. I'm Elder Nathaniel, Israel United in Christ. YouTube likes to shut our channels down, as some of you have noticed, ever so often. Subscribing to join IUIC will assure you will always stay connected to our YouTube accounts. We want to do our best to make sure this truth gets out. Please click and join our subscriber YouTube channel called Join IUIC to stay linked to all of our videos. So again, please make sure you subscribe to this and join IUIC channel to get your latest updates on all our YouTube channels. Shalom.